Tundra may disappoint. Are our expectations too high? Well, good morning, everybody. How are you today? Pretty cloudy here. And that's right, I'm starting to think that the new Toyota Tundra, you know, the redesigned new Tundra, may disappoint and that maybe our expectations are a little too high. And I gotta say, I'm guilty of that myself. You know, when I first heard that they were redesigning the Tundra, which I love the Tundra, by the way, I got to thinking of all these grandiose things, right? All this stuff that they could do to it that I was expecting that they would do to it. But now I'm thinking maybe my expectations are a little too high. You know, that maybe they're not going to create the Tundra that I think they should. You know, first of all, we have to be realistic, right? I mean, if you think about it, we're talking about Toyota here, right? And Toyota has proven that they're really not interested in being the most cutting edge brand out there, right? They go with more reliable parts, proven parts, maybe tech that's not the latest and greatest, screens that aren't the biggest and brightest. They do that for a reason, of course, right? I mean, obviously, they do that for reliability's sake. I mean, if you use tech that's been out for a while, that all the bugs have been worked out of, you're gonna have a more reliable product. So I think all of us, me included, who think that this new Tundra is gonna be some earth-shattering, cutting-edge truck, probably a little bit wrong. So what am I talking about? Well, let's start with the body. You know, there have been several renderings out there, and I think the closer we get to the finished product, which is supposed to be December this year, right, the more accurate these renderings are. And I gotta say, I wasn't overly excited on the last round that I saw, right? Primarily because the Tundra looked kind of squatty. It almost looked like they reduced the roof line a little bit. Makes the truck look lowered. Makes it look lower to the ground. I don't want that in a truck. If anything, I want the opposite. I want it to be higher. That's why I lift my trucks, right? So I don't know that I'm real happy with what I've seen as far as the renderings go. The front end, the grill work. I don't know, it just didn't really turn me on. So it's kind of ugly, I gotta say. Number two, power. You know, this is a big question mark when it comes to the new Tundra. There's all kinds of rumors and things out there, right? The latest I've heard is that the lower trim, the lower level Tundras are gonna have the Toyota Tacoma V6. You know, that engine in this truck, a smaller, lighter truck, is anemic at best, right? I couldn't imagine putting that engine in a bigger, heavier truck. I mean, it's gonna be a dog if they do that. Now I realize they can tweak a little, they can change the tuning a little bit, but still, that little motor in that big truck? Yeah, I don't think so. What about the twin turbo four? They're gonna put a four-cylinder motor potentially in a Toyota Tundra? I think probably more likely it's going to be a V6 turbo, which might be okay, but that then brings up the question about reliability. You know, a lot of people say that the twin turbos, or turbos, I guess, altogether, are just not as reliable. Is Toyota going to do that? Kind of gets away from what they're really all about, right? I don't know. As far as some kind of a hybrid, you know, there were a lot of rumors out there in the beginning about a hybrid, some kind of an electric motor in the Tundra. I don't think that's going to happen. Fuel economy, number three. You know, we all have these great expectations. I remember when it was first talked about, this new redesigned Tundra, that somehow it was going to get these massive fuel economy numbers, right? That it would be in the 30s, maybe even higher, closer to 40 miles per gallon. I don't think that's going to happen. I think we're going to see an increase. But you know, to increase from where it's at right now really doesn't take much, right? I think it's probably going to be more maybe in the 19 to 21 mile per gallon range in the city and maybe somewhere in the 25, 26 mile per gallon range on the freeway, somewhere combined in the, I don't know, maybe 24, maybe 25 mile per gallon range. It's going to be interesting to see. Do I think it's going to be some kind of hypermiler? No, no, I'd be shocked if it was. Number four, it's going to be too basic. Will it be too basic? Again, Toyota likes to stick with the tried and true technology that's out there, the tried and true fabrics and materials that are out there, right? I think that they run the risk of putting something out that's too pedestrian for today. I mean, let's face it, in a lot of the other models, we got a lot of flash out there, right? All this embroidery and stitching and all this shiny new material, even the colors on the trucks, right? Now, I will say Toyota has made some improvements as far as that goes. I mean, I'm standing in front of a voodoo blue, right? It's a pretty striking color. But generally, their trucks are kind of blasé. White, silver, gray, black, tan, maybe. Tan's pushing it. That's kind of cutting edge a little bit for Toyota. But they need to be a little bit more progressive, I think, at least with colors. Is that going to happen? Yeah, I kind of doubt it. Number five, new model problems. And this is probably the biggest risk for Toyota. You know, let's say that they do come out with this cutting edge truck, right? All this brand new technology, all this new stuff, these new materials. But you know what comes with that, right? You and I, we become the test dummies then. Because until you put this brand new stuff out there in the real world and let you and me put it through its paces, you don't really know how it's going to turn out, right? I mean, you can test it in the factory as much as you want, but you and I are the real test. So what happens if they put this brand new redesigned Tundra out there and it has problems? Remember way back when the Tundra first came out? Remember some of the issues it had back then? It wasn't known as the most reliable truck in the world until they kind of tweaked it a little bit over the years. Does Toyota have those years now to tweak it, to get all the bugs out of it and make it right? I don't think so. I think there's too much competition out there, right? I mean, you're going up against a lot of really nice trucks out there now. So I don't know that Toyota's really going to be willing to take that risk. Even though, at least me, I'd love to see them take that risk. I'd love to see them put out a cutting edge, redesigned from the wheels up truck. But I think we're going to be disappointed. I don't think they're going to do that. You're going to see some tweaks. That's what you're going to see. You're going to see some redesigned body panels. You're going to see a little bit more aerodynamic look. Maybe that's the reason for the squatty roof. I don't know. And probably some different engine combinations because they have to. I mean, they're going to have to work on fuel economy. The Tundra right now is horrible. So you know they're going to have to address that and do something. But I don't think we're going to see some kind of earth-shattering truck out there. I just don't think it's going to happen. I think the new Tundra may just disappoint, and only because our expectations are probably too high. After all, it is Toyota, and they're very conservative. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think from all the information you've heard or seen out there. Am I right? Do you think the new Tundra is going to disappoint? Or do you think it's going to be some beaming star in the world of full-size pickups? I'd be curious to know. Also, real quick, if you're interested, I have two other channels. RobMotive JT, all about my 2020 Jeep Gladiator. And RobMotive Civic, all about my experiences with the Honda Civic Sport Hatchback and the Honda Civic Type R. Check them out. If you're interested, please consider subscribing. Don't forget to click that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. And do me a favor, smash that subscribe button on the way out. Thanks for watching. Stay safe out there. Bye.